Hello students, today we are going to continue the remaining part of direct and indirect speech, that is different forms of sentences changes into indirect form, that is assertive sentence, then comes exclamatory, interrogation and optative sentences. Here we are going to study how these type of sentences are transformed direct into indirect speech. Let me tell you first thing, that is assertive sentence. Before that, I would like to explain what is the meaning of assertive sentence. It is a statement. These statements may be positive, negative, true or false. When you want to convert this assertive sentence into indirect narration, we have to follow certain rules. For example, I'll read one example. She says, I am writing a letter to my brother. This is direct. In indirect speech, it comes, she says remains as it is. Because in says, is it in present tense? The tenses will not change here. That she is writing a letter to her brother. Second is, she says, I was not writing a letter to my brother. Indirect speech says that she says that she was not writing a letter to her brother. Okay, like this way the sentences changes. You can follow the examples. Next comes imperative sentence. We have already studied this. Imperative sentences means command, order or request. Now the reporting verb is changed according to reported speech into order in case the sentence gives a direct command. Now I'll explain you with the example. The teacher said to me, shut the door. Now this is the order given by the teacher. So in indirect narration, it comes, the teacher ordered me to shut the door. Now let me give you the example of request. In case of reporting verb, it changes according to reported speech into a request in case the sentence makes a request. He said to me, shut the door. Now if it is request, you have to say he requested me to shut the door. In case of imperative sentences, we make use of TO, not that. Suppose if the sentence is in giving advice or asking something. So the example will be, he said to me, you should work hard to pass the exam. This is advice. Let us see how it changes into indirect speech. He advised me, instead of he said to me, here since it is advice, in case of indirect narration, it changes into he advised me that I should work hard to pass the exam. You changes into I. Now, the reporting verb is changed according to reported speech into forbade. Forbade means to prevent someone from doing something. Example, he said to me not to smoke. In case of indirect speech, it changes into he said changes into he forbade me to smoke. Forbade means prevents. Comes interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence means asking question. In case of interrogative sentences, you can use the words like asked, questions, inquired, etc. Now to convert interrogative sentences into indirect speech, certain rules to be followed. If the reporting speech is having the reporting verb at its start, then you have to make use of if or whether. If the reporting speech is having interrogative words, I am repeating once again, if the reporting speech is having interrogative words such as who, when, how, why, when, then neither, if is used nor any other word is added. You have to use if, not any other word. For your kind information, I have given some interrogative examples. You can go through it. There are two columns. One is direct and another one is indirect, which helps you to understand to solve the direct-indirect speech very easily. Next is exclamatory sentences. Now those sentences which express our feelings and emotions are called exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences always ends with exclamatory mark. Now to change exclamatory sentences into indirect speech, you have to follow certain rule. For example, sometimes there will be interjections such as alas, ha, hooray, etc. in the reported speech, then they are omitted. Omitted means you have to delete, you have to cancel it along with the sign of exclamation. Now, reporting verb that is said is always replaced with exclaimed in case of exclamatory sentences. You can add joy, exclaimed with sorrow. It is depend upon the sentences. It is depend upon the narration. In case there is what or how at the beginning of the reported speech, then they are replaced with very or very great in indirect speech. Now see, for your kind information, I have highlighted the words. The exclamatory sentence becomes an assertive sentence. So you have to follow these rules, and that helps you to solve the examples very easily. In the same way, I have given some exclamatory examples. Please go through the chart and write it down in your notebook and try to solve independently. Now the last is optative sentences. Now what is this optative? Those sentences which express hope, prayer or wish are called optative sentences. Usually there is a mark of exclamation at the end of optative sentence. Now again here there are some rules to be followed. In case the reported speech starts with the word may, I already highlighted the word, then the reporting verb said is replaced with the word prayed. In case the reported speech starts with the word would, it changes into wished. The same way, may changes into might. Keep in your mind, children, here exclamation mark should be omitted. Now again, in indirect speech, the optative sentences become assertive sentences. I have given some examples. Please go through it and solve. Dear students, I am sure that the concept is clear. Kindly follow the chart of the previous lecture, that is direct indirect speech. With the help of the rules, solve all the examples whichever I have given in this lecture. And kindly, it is an assignment, kindly write in the notebook. Thank you. Have a nice day.